A lot of people asked me in the comment section why they are unable to use edit points on shapes in Microsoft Word, Excel, and PowerPoint. To answer this question, let me clarify a few things for you first. One reason why you are unable to use edit points on certain shapes could be an older version, specifically 2007 or earlier. To demonstrate this, I have installed Office 2007 and Office 2010 inside a virtual machine, and here is what you need to know before you start using edit points. In Word 2007 or PowerPoint 2007, if you insert a shape and then go to the Format tab and click the Edit Shapes drop-down menu, then you might find that Edit Points is disabled by default. That is because, in 2007 and earlier versions of Microsoft Office, you cannot use Edit Points on predefined shapes. Mostly the users did the mistake of trying to use the Edit Points on predefined shapes, which is not possible in the earlier versions. The edit points works best with the Freeform shape in 2007 and earlier versions that you can find under the Lines section of Shapes in the Insert tab. The other workaround could be that you first convert the predefined shape into Freeform by using the Convert to Freeform option in PowerPoint 2007. After conversion, you can easily use the Edit Points command. Unfortunately, the Convert to Freeform option is not available in Word and Excel 2007, so you only can use Edit Points in Word and Excel over the Freeform shape alone. In PowerPoint 2010 and later versions, you can again easily use the Edit Points on all the predefined shapes. But that also sticks to the PowerPoint alone, and if you try to use the edit points in Word 2010 on predefined shapes, then you will again find the edit points is disabled for them. Most of the PowerPoint tutorials that you see on my YouTube channel, where I am using the edit points command from the Shape Format tab, have been created in PowerPoint 2016 and PowerPoint 365. So, there is no problem using edit points on any of the shapes that you use through the Insert tab. So either you need to upgrade to the latest version or use PowerPoint to convert shapes into Freeform, and then you can copy and paste those shapes into Word and Excel as well. I hope you got my point and have learned something new and interesting. Let me know by liking, sharing, and commenting on this video.